Alright guys, welcome back to the channel. In this video, we will see how we can create and activate Python virtual environment for the Python projects in Windows computer. So here, in order to explain this, what I have done is, in my desktop, I have created a folder called as test, and I have opened this folder in my Visual Studio Code text editor. Here you guys can see the folder name is test, and I have a file called as main.py in this test folder. So now the first thing is why we have to create a virtual environment. Now when we create projects using Python programming language, our project will depend on multiple dependencies. And if we don't use the virtual environment, then we have to install those dependencies globally. Let us say in our computer, we have 15 or 20 different projects and they depend on different dependencies. And some projects may depend on a particular version of package, and some other project may depend on a completely different version of that package. So at that time, it will be difficult to manage the projects. And in order to solve that, what we can do is we can use the virtual environments. By using these virtual environments, we can have separate, independent, project-specific environments where we install all the packages and other things for that particular project. So because of that, there will not be any conflict. We can easily manage our projects. Now, in order to use the virtual environments, first we have to create a virtual environment. Now, in order to create the virtual environment, first we have to go to the folder where we have saved our project. Here, I have the project in my test folder. So it makes sense to keep all the virtual environment files here in this project folder. So to create the virtual environment, we first go to the folder where we have the project here, in this case, desktop test, and then we execute a command, and that command is Python space hyphen M space venv space, and then the name that we want to give for the folder, which will contain all the files which are part of the virtual environment. Generally, venv.venv, these are used. You guys can give any name, for example, my venv. Here, for the demonstration purpose, I will use venv. So Python hyphen M venv is the command. The last venv that I have used here is the name for the folder. If I hit the enter key and run this command, then what happens is in this test folder, we can see a new folder is created with the name venv. And here Visual Studio displays a message stating that we noticed a new environment has been created. Do you want to select it for workspace folder? We will click on yes. And now once this command is complete, here in the test folder, we can see the venv folder. If I open up that, we can find some folders and some files. Here we will mainly open up the scripts folder, which contains the Python pip and the commands to activate and deactivate the virtual environment. So here, in order to use this virtual environment for this particular project, we have to activate this virtual environment. So in order to activate the virtual environment, we have to execute this activate command, which is present inside the scripts folder, which is present inside the venv folder, which is present inside the test folder. So here I'm in the test folder. So I will write in venv slash scripts slash activate. Now, once I do that, for some of you guys, the command will go through and the virtual environment will be activated. For some of you guys, you may see this particular message. This is about the Microsoft execution policy, which is blocking us from executing this particular command here. So what we have to do is we have to change the execution policy, and then we have to run the command to activate the virtual environment. So here, first what we do is we will check the execution policy. So we will type in get minus or hyphen execution policy. Once we run this command, we can see restricted. So in order to change this execution policy, we have to execute a command. I will provide that command in the description box. You guys can copy and run that. So that command is set execution policy hyphen scope current user hyphen execution policy unrestricted and then hyphen force. Again, the command will be in the description box. Now, once I execute this command, nothing happens. Now, if I check the execution policy again by using get execution policy, I can see now it is unrestricted. So now what we can do is we can execute the command which is used for activating the virtual environment. So it will be venv /scripts/activate. If I run this now, here we can see the virtual environment has been activated by looking at this venv, which is displayed in a different color, just like this. And now what we can do is we can install the dependencies or the packages that our project needs. And those dependencies will be installed in this virtual environment, which are used for this particular project. So this is how we can create and activate the virtual environment for Python projects in Windows computer. If you like the video, hit the like button. If you don't like it, hit the dislike button. If you have anything to say, write that in the comment box. For more tutorials, subscribe to the channel.